Hi, I'm Lashay Grissom. I'm a student from Cicely L. Tyson, and I am here to talk about who I am.
What's interesting about why I chose these topics is because I want people to see how loving and caring and kind and sweet my family are, and how much I love them and how much they did for me and how much time we spend together and why they are so important. Why we do so many family functions and go out to dinner and do many other kind of things. Like my sweet 16, it was fun and enjoyable, and that's why I'm here to talk about my family. My friends, they make life worth the while. They're so fun. They so kind and they're wonderful to talk to. They're always there for me, and there's someone I can count on. Interesting about my religion is that it's a reflection of me, my family, our life, how we live. It's it shows like how we believe, and it shows us how much we love the Lord and why we care so much about it. That's why that's what's most interesting about my religion. Why my family is important to me is because they are the most people that I trust in the world. They're there for me no matter what. They are someone I can count on. They're someone that there for me. There's someone who's kind and caring and special, has a special place in my heart and forever will be. My friends are important to me is because they make my life fun. They make wonderful memories with me, wonderful experiences. They make me do things that I was never comfortable with and make me feel different and make me see different things. Why my religion is important to me, or my religion is important to me, because it's my special place. It's a place where I can be myself. It's a place where I can talk to someone that will actually listen and someone that cares for me so much. And it's important to me entirely because it's myself. I feel like having family that's there to support you, it can make you feel better. It can make you feel different, because a life without family is like a life without nothing. And you don't want to have a life without nothing, because you need someone there that you could talk to forever. And it's the same with friends. Friends are there to make your life better. They're somebody that you're supposed to trust entirely. And of course, without me, without my religion, I am nothing. It's a reflection of me. And if I didn't have a reflection of myself, nobody would know who I am. A personal experience I have with these three things that's important to me with my family, they show kindness to me anytime. I can be mad, angry, don't matter. They'll still be there for me no matter what. You know, we could be arguing, we could be stop talking, but no matter what, they'll forever love me and I'll forever love them. That's my personal experience, and they're truly amazing to me. And I have wonderful parents, wonderful siblings, and wonderful family. For friends, my friends, they're always, you know, there for me. Some may not, some may I just have to choose who we want to hang out with. They are there for me no matter what, when I need them, when I could call on them. They're always excited, you know, to be like around me. We could play a lot, and it's somebody who's like my age that I can match energy with, that I could be around with and be myself with. For my religion is something that's personal. Praying and reading my Bible and speaking about it and going to church and doing everything that has beneficial to my religion is a personal experience for me, and why I think is something that you'll like, because it's something that's calm and soothing and it helps your mind. Why I'm sharing this is because my family helped me get through so many personal matters, like school, health, you know, mental things. And they helped me get through a lot. And so that's why I'm sharing it. And same as my friends. My friends helped me get through a lot as well. They're always there when I need to talk. And they're always there when I need to cry and laugh and all of the above. My religion is there for everything. If I feel a type of way, I just read my Bible and I go about my day. I spend hours, minutes, seconds, doesn't matter how long, is because I need something to calm my mind. I need something to read, something to make me feel good. And that's what I have my religion for, and my friends and my family. And so this is why I am sharing this, and it's what helped me. And I'm not saying it can help you, but you know, just give it a try, because it might help you. Something that you should do to help, you know, bring this project to another level is talk to your family, talk to your friends, you know, whatever religion you support, do that. Anything that makes you comfortable and is your safe spot, that's something that you should do, something that you should work on, because it's helpful and it's something that you'll need to, you know, go through life. Thank you for watching this segment. I hope you enjoyed, and see you again.
Hello, my name is Jaden Jean. I am 15 years old and I attend Sicily L. Tyson. I like to hang out with family, eat, sleep, play sports, and take photos. I've been playing soccer since the age of 6 and have been getting better and better every year. Currently playing for Cedar Stars Academy. Seeing players my age like Julian Hall, Kevin Civilian, Yamin Lamel, and one of my very own former teammates, Julian Bretus, playing for the first teams motivates me more because they are my age, which means I can get to where they are at with hard work and dedication. On my free time, I usually train or work out alone, hang out with friends or family, play video games, read, and do homework. One moment in my life when I wanted to quit was my sophomore year. My coach always told me I needed to play more physical and that the club I was playing for was just for the hype. I wanted to quit because I felt like people were just taking me as a joke. But with the love I had for the game, I realized no one can tell me to quit no matter how bad I was playing. Music and fashion is also important to me because music can help you for all types of moods. And fashion can help you boost your mood by making you feel better and feel yourself. Another thing I look into is cinematography. Even though I just started about 2 years ago, I find joy in it and would like to pursue that as a career. And for many opportunities it may come with. All the memorable parts of my movie is that I had fun and it was entertaining me. I had something to do and I wasn't bored.
The biggest challenge I encountered was continuity and attendance. So I couldn't really record. So I had to record,
I overcame my challenges was I came to school more and I re-recorded the next day.
The unexpected obstacles that I had to deal with is that I had to restart my whole movie because nobody could really be a monster. They can't have a monster face. My inspiration for my movie was scary videos and prank videos on YouTube because I like them and it made me laugh.
Hello everyone, I'm your host, Ernst June. Welcome to Show and Tell, where I will share what's important to me and why. Let's take a look.
I have a true passion for playing football. There wasn't really a plan behind any of this. It kind of just happened, and that's part of the reason why I love it so much.
What's interesting about football is the experiences. For example, my first sack. This game I was determined as I wanted to improve my stats for the year. I remember the joy I seen from my teammates on the sideline, the smile on my coach's face, and the excitement from my brothers on the field. Truly a heartwarming moment. The reason I chose football as something I'm very passionate about is because I see it in my future. When I first started, it was very difficult. It became my whole life because of the constant workouts and practices. It's very time consuming, but it's very worth it. Football is special, and it can make the world a better place because it brings a bunch of kids from different backgrounds, cultures, and forces them to build a brotherhood that's important when trusting each other on the field. It builds character as it can make or break it.
It all started when I was in middle school. I was freshly finding new friends and trying out new things. The common sport in this country was football, so I started to watch it and I enjoyed it. My friends used to always play at the park, so I would ask my mom to sign me up for football, but she couldn't afford to do so. So I waited until high school, and I pursued it further, and I was starting by my junior year. It's important that my audience knows how far I want to take the sports route, because it gives them an idea of my determination and goals. There was many times along this journey where I wanted to quit and felt like I wasn't good enough, but stuck with it to follow my dreams. The audience should take in the lessons to not give up and follow your dreams. They can do this by starting with the right perspective and think about what they already enjoy doing. We hope you enjoyed this segment of Show and Tell. I'm your host, Ernst June. See you next time.
Hello everyone, I'm your host Azair Little, and welcome to Show and Tell, where I will share what is important to me and why it is. Let's take a look.
Something that is important to me is my family. You know, the people that I live with, my siblings, my mom, people like that, my immediate family. It is important to me because those are people that I see in my everyday life. Those are the people that I grew up with. It should be important to you because those are the people that you will know and love for the rest of your life. You show them respect and they show you respect.
Connecting with your family will always and forever be important. You always have somebody to talk to and depend on because they're always going to be your family no matter what. I think you guys should connect with your family more and share more with your family because it puts you in the right mindset.
Family is important. Family will forever and always be important no matter what. That is an unbreakable bond even if you don't talk to them. Family is the memories you make with people. You call people family for a reason. That's an unbreakable bond. Mm-hmm. Family is important. The ones you call family are the ones that you have an unbreakable bond with no matter what. They should always have your back, and you should always have theirs. Family is everything. Family should be important to you because when you have family, you have everything. When you have no family, you have nobody to talk to, nobody to vent to, no matter who you call your family, who you don't call your family. That sound good to you?
We hope you enjoyed this segment on Show and Tell. I'm your host, Azair Little. See you next time.
Sierra Clement, and I currently attend Cecil Tyson Middle High. Something that's important to me will be my heritage. By sharing my personal experiences and the aspect of my heritage, I hope to connect with you all. Let's get started. It's all about exploring the rich cultures, traditions, and history of Guyana. From the delicious food, vibrant music, and festivals, there's so much to be discovered. My heritage is important to me because it connects me to my roots, history, and cultural identity. It helps me understand where I come from and can provide me with a sense of belonging and pride. Embracing my heritage allows me to appreciate the diversity and richness of my background. Growing up in a Guyanese household, I was always surrounded by vibrant traditions and flavors of my heritage. One of my favorite memories is Caribbean Day with my family, when we would go to the park, listen to music, eat food, and dance, all with different cultures there. By sharing my stories and traditions, I can inspire others, embrace their own heritage, and create a more diverse world. It enriches the lives of others by broadening their perspective and fostering an appreciation for diversity. We hope that you enjoy this segment on Show and Tell. I'm your host, Sierra Clement, and I'll see you next time.
Hello everyone, my name is Ayende Adams. Welcome to Show and Tell. I'm gonna be letting y'all know what's important to me and why it's important. Let's take a little dive into it.
So Final Destination started in the year of 2023, month August. I was looking for some back to school hoodies and I just couldn't get down with any that they were selling. So I said, let me do something about it. And that's how Final Destination started. I'm gonna give y'all the real. It's not as easy as it looks. Let's really get into the real scoop of having a clothing brand. It started off with going on TikTok. That's the new generation news. I had to go on TikTok. They told me download Canva, get some blank mockups, and be ready to design for hours. The designing process ain't nothing easy. You gotta have patience and creativity. So that's exactly what I had.
The next step, making sure people like it. You can make the hardest hoodies to yourself, but if nobody else likes it, you're not gonna sell and you're doing it for nothing. I went through 10 of the hardest critiques I know, and they kept it real. If I should keep working or if I think I should start selling, they told me to keep working. So what did I do? Instead of being a hard-headed little dummy, I said, let me get back on the grind, and I made some more and showed them this is what I'm passionate about, and they told me it was hard. So just stay consistent and listen to critiques. That's all. The last, or close to the last, finding a manufacturer. You got to find a trusted manufacturer who won't scam you and who's going to do it to your liking, because there's a lot of people who like to freestyle on your clothes, and I wasn't with it. I said I'm dropping quality over quantity, so that's exactly what I looked for. I paid the good money, got the good clothing, and there's great graphics, so that's the next step. Let me tell you how the last step on marketing. You got to reach an audience, or you got to reach buyers. People will not just magically know that you make clothes now. You got to make sure you sell, promote, and let them know why they need it. You do all of those steps, you're a great seller, and your business going to run great. I'm Ayende Adams, the CEO of Final Destination. Make sure y'all shop Final and listen to these steps. Your clothing brand going to grow just like mine's.
Well, that was our segment of Show and Tell. I hope you enjoyed. Catch you next time. I'm your host, Ayende Adams. Make sure y'all shop final.
Breaks. My life is out of control. I'm telling you, nobody's safe. I've been living my life limbo. My ice came with a tray. I'm so high, gotta have my face. Been living my life limbo. My ice came with a tray. I'm so high, gotta have my face.
Bateu saudade, amor. Quero te ver, amor. Doido pra te abraçar, te dar um beijo. Sentir seu corpo inteiro é meu desejo. Eu quero seu calor, viver essa emoção. Seu cheiro pulsa forte o meu coração. Minha menina, você é linda. O seu nome é linda. Tudo fica mais bonito quando ela chega.